This is video 42 of 101. This video is about water. I'm gonna tell you guys a story first. When I moved here to BC the first week, so I drove here from Ontario, and during that first week, I hardly drank any water because I was still in my road trip mentality where it's like, if you drink more water, you're gonna have to pee in some weird bathroom, so just try to drink as little as possible. And when I got to BC, obviously there were so many things going on, and I just hardly drank any water, and I was feeling like absolute shit when I moved. I was like, what am I doing with my life? Why am I here? I'm so confused. I just don't know what's going on, and like, I feel so tired, and I feel so lethargic, and I just don't wanna do anything, and I was just so unmotivated. And I was talking to my friend, and I was on the phone with her, and I was like, holy shit, I haven't drinking any water in like a week. No wonder I feel like shit. And so I went and I just drank like a liter right there, or like half a liter or something like that. And I was like, wow, I feel a lot better. And then I was fine and I just continued on with my regular water schedule and everything was good to go. So that story is a lesson to you that water is absolutely vital. If you're ever feeling really tired or you have a headache or anything like that, drink water. It may not be the cause of your ailment, but it definitely will help no matter what. Water is absolutely vital to all of our bodily processes, like removing toxins, helping with our digestion, and pretty much everything else. Every single cell in our body is fundamentally integrated with water. Our bodies are like 80% water, our lungs are 90% water, our brains are 70% water. That's crazy. There's so much water, and we need to be constantly replenishing that water because it's being constantly used up by our bodily functions. We need water to survive. If you're ever feeling really tired or if you have a headache or anything like that, it's probably due to dehydration. Even a tiny drop in hydration can lead to mental fog, confusion, tiredness, fatigue. So I'm going to talk in this video about how we can set up water habits so that we don't even have to think about water. We just know what we need to drink, we know when to drink it, and we have the right tools. So it's not even something we have to think about, it just happens and we just feel great. All the times in my life where I've ever felt really like sad or down or like my skin's really shitty and I'm just like meh about life, because I haven't been keeping up with my water schedule, because I haven't been drinking enough, and so my body is just slowly deteriorates if I'm not drinking enough water, and that just makes me feel really crappy. So I definitely want to be at my 100%, and that means having 100% of my water intake. So we know we need to drink water, but how much and when? Well, a really great way to determine how much water you should be drinking every day is to take your body weight in pounds, cut it in half, and then just tack ounces onto the end of there, and that's the amount of ounces you should be drinking in a day. For an example, I weigh about 125 pounds-ish. If I cut that in half, that's 62.5. So that's 62.5 ounces a day. If I divide that by 8 ounces, which is 1 cup of water, that gives me just under 8 cups of water a day, which is roughly 2 liters. Just for some context here, 1 cup of water is 8 ounces or 250 milliliters. A bottle of water that you're typically going to buy at like a gas station is going to be 500 milliliters or 2 cups of water or 16 ounces. And the jars that I drink from are 1 liter or 1,000 milliliters or 32 ounces. And so for me to drink 62.5 ounces a day, divided that by 8 ounces, that's just under 8 cups of water. 8 cups of water is 2 liters of water. So I just drink 2 of these a day and I'm good to go. So that's just kind of like a basic ratio of how much water you can be drinking. If you find you need more, go for it. I wouldn't say go below that though, because sometimes we're never gonna be thirsty enough for 2 liters of water in a day, but it's definitely something we need to be drinking anyways. Even if I'm not thirsty, I need to be drinking the water anyway. So it's never like, oh, I'm not really thirsty, I'm not gonna drink water. You need it anyways. You're not gonna feel thirsty until you really, really need the water. And honestly, drinking from a straw just makes everything so much easier. And I know it's probably the most first world problem ever, but literally like tipping this up to drink from, it's just annoying. I just don't want to do it. I would rather just be sitting anywhere where I can just like bring this to my face and I don't have to move my face at all. And I can drink the water that way. So highly recommend that. I'll put some links down below on how you guys can get stuff like this, because you get it once and you're good to go. I mean, unless you break them like I did. But you won't do that because you're good and you're not clumsy. Maybe you are. So by 3. So that's how much water we should be drinking. So when do we drink the water? There are a couple guidelines about when to drink water during the day. You don't have to follow these, but I do recommend them because you're going to feel a lot better if you follow them, because we're just going along with what our body does. The best thing to do when you first wake up, and I know eating fruit is there, but that's the first meal. The first thing you want to do when you wake up is drink water. And I know this is probably the last thing a lot of people want to do when you aren't in the habit of it, but just start getting in the habit. Just say, you know what, I gotta drink this water. It's gonna make me feel a lot more energized and it's gonna help my metabolism throughout the day. it basically just helps to wake up your body after coming out of sleep. I love drinking this liter of water in the morning because I bloat way less during the day. I feel way more energized. My skin looks awesome because when I'm hydrated, my skin is hydrated, it looks full and plump and shiny and great. Otherwise, I have like acne scars and then my skin starts to like sink and you can kind of see them. So I definitely drink as much water as I possibly can. You are definitely gonna feel the benefits if you start drinking a lot of water in the morning. Drinking a lot of water can actually dilute our digestive enzymes. And so in this sense, you definitely wanna make sure you're not drinking a liter of water just before you eat a meal or a lot just after you eat a meal because it's gonna impact your digestion negatively. So a really good rule of thumb is to drink your water 30 minutes before a meal or 2 hours after your meal. What I typically do then is I'll have my 1 liter in the morning, I have 500 milliliters half an hour before lunch, and then another 500 milliliters half an hour before dinner. And this isn't to say you can't drink water during your meal because of course you might get parched a little bit or you just wanna, you know, clear some flavors, it's totally fine to take sips of water. But in terms of your main intake of water, you definitely wanna make sure you're not mixing it in with meal times. In the beginning, it may just seem a little pointless, but as you start to get into these water habits, you'll definitely start to notice a difference when you do this kind of stuff. You're gonna bloat way less when you drink your water before your meal. I have found this every single time. You know, after your meals, I recommend just waiting about 2 hours or so to do your, like, lots of water if you forget to do it before the meal. But, I mean, honestly, these are just guidelines. Like, you don't have to do any of these things. If you eat a meal and then you're like, oh my god, I'm absolutely parched, I just need to drink like a whole cup of water, go for it. I'm not gonna stop you, I'm just saying these are some great things to keep in mind to help with bloating, to help with energy, to help with digestion as well. And then lastly, it's probably not best to drink all this water before you go to bed. Water is kind of really great for bodily activity, and so drinking that at night, it might kind of just like wake up your body when you're trying to get it to go to sleep. Also, you might have to wake up in the middle of the night to go pee. We definitely want to try to be drinking all of our water earlier in the day, half an hour before our meals, 2 hours afterwards. If you have to drink stuff at night, obviously that's totally okay, but we don't want to be just like chugging a liter of water before we go to bed. That's probably not going to make us feel the best, and our sleep quality may not be as optimal as we'd like it to be. So if we just consciously set up times to drink water, we will never have to worry if we're getting enough, because we just will be. Now lastly, I want to make a note about the kinds of water that are available to the public right now. Majority of water in North America, bottled water, tap water, has fluoride and other minerals in it. Fluoride is meant to help strengthen our teeth. Alright, government, thanks a lot, but I'm gonna worry about my teeth health. You don't have to put shit in my water to make my teeth better. I'll take care of them myself. Thanks a lot. So, fluoride, honestly, I don't recommend it. It kind of fucks with you. Maybe it's controversial. I'm gonna put the information down below so you guys can decide for yourself, but for me, I don't want you putting shit in my water. I just want the clearest, pure water that I can possibly get. And so for that, what I do is I go to my grocery stores and I fill up my like 11.5 liter jugs of water at the reverse osmosis machine thing. And so that allows me to not have any minerals in my water and it's just still clear and purified. And so one other thing that I'm actually gonna be getting soon, so I don't ever have to go to the grocery store and fill up all my water. It's like two really big steel cylinders and the top one has charcoal filters in it, and so you'll just fill up the water from wherever the tap. Gravity will pull the water through the charcoal filters and then you're getting just your pure refined water at the bottom there. Absolutely no chemicals or anything necessary. So this is something I'm going to be investing in soon so I can have it for life. I'm really excited so I don't ever have to rely on anything else for my water. I can just have my pure clean water to myself. And that's really exciting for me. I'll put a lot more information about water purification down below, as well as alkaline water, because sometimes that can help people with health issues or recovery as well. So the final takeaway is that you need water. You need it, okay? You just need it. There's no way around it. If you don't drink water for a few days, you're gonna die. Like, not just like, oh, I'm gonna feel really crappy for a while. No, no, you're gonna die if you don't drink water. So you need it, all right? So all you have to do is just set up the times of day that you're gonna drink water, get into the habit, drink the water, and then watch your life fall together.